promise and my love both never to come back.
Hey everybody, this is Jeff Crow with Rebel One Tactical.
Hey, this is Hank with Everyday Carry 101. Today we're going to be discussing the Glock line of pistols. We're going to try to do a quick review, but it's not going to be as quick as we normally want to do. Pretty much right here in this row, what you're looking at is you're looking at our full-size line of Glocks here. In this row, we have the compact size, and then these two are technically subcompact. Now, this is a Glock 30, it's a 45 ACP. This is more in comparison with these type pistols, the compact. However, Glock classifies the Glock 30 as a subcompact. So first we'll get started briefly. So what's the difference when you're talking everyday carry? Well, it really depends on you, your body style, what type of clothes you normally wear on an everyday basis. Some people usually, you know, especially in today's economy, they want to have that one go-to gun. And in my opinion, you can't really beat a Glock. Now, I'm also a big fan of Smith & Wesson M&P. However, with my history with these weapons, and with Jeff's history with these guns, both of us actually love them. Now, Jeff's, like I said before in another video, Jeff's an H&K guy, but he's also a reserve police officer, and he has to carry a Glock 22 on duty. But Jeff's been carrying a Glock 23 longer than, you know, I've had my permit, probably longer than I've been carrying a gun, I'm sure. So he trusts the Glock with his life. I trust one with mine. But when we get into different sizes, again, your mileage may vary. Now, you might want to get with someone like Jeff over at Raven One and maybe try out a few guns, maybe handle them, wear them in a few different holsters. Now, we got some holsters over here just to give you some ideas. We'll name drop the companies. But, and you can do Google searches, you can do other reviews, because we don't want to get too far in depth, and we're not going to go into all the specs on these guns. But we just want you to know and be aware of what's available to you, and maybe some of the differences between the different generations of these guns, and whether or not, you know, you might need them. Okay, so we'll start off with our full-size line. Right here, this is a Gen 4 Glock 17. And this is 9mm. It holds 17 rounds of 9mm. Now, if you see, this isn't necessarily a stock gun. This is my personal gun, and I do some things that I particularly want on my gun. Now, would I be comfortable with taking a stock Glock and trusting my life to it? Yes. But over the years, I've gotten to know what I like. Just because I like these items don't mean that you should go out and buy them, because they may not work for you. So I'm not one of these guys to tell you, hey, just because I like it and I think it works, you should do the same thing. I'll give you an example. Jeff's not a big fan of night sights. He's just never seen the use for them. But I have. So, I mean, just because I run night sights, I can't necessarily tell Jeff, go out and buy you night sights. You gotta have them. That's not true, okay? I run a beaver tail grip. Just it enhances my grip. A lot of you 1911 guys that really love the grip angle, but you hate the Glock grip angle, which, to be honest, I hate the Glock grip angle too. That's why I add these to my guns. It really straightens it up and makes it better. It won't go too far in depth, but this is Glock 19. It's a full duty size gun. When I mean duty size, typically we reference police, military, that they would want to have as their primary sidearm. But all these guns probably serve on duty at some point with some police officer, whether undercover or carrying every day as a cop, or they carry, you know, just taking their wife out to dinner and the family and kids to a movie. All right, so that's the 17. Many police departments do carry the Glock 17 and 9mm. A lot of people think they all carry 40, but all right, so next, here's your Glock 40. Jeff, it carries 15 rounds?
Yes.
40. 15 rounds of 40 in the full-size gun. This particular model is compensated. Again, they're not as common, and with the compensation, sometimes that helps with muzzle rise. A lot of competition shooters like them because it keeps that barrel from jumping or rising up as much. Now, the recoil in this gun is not bad at all. especially in this full size. People rant and rave about this gun. I mean, every cop, I think Glock says 60% of the law enforcement community carry Glocks. It's also a full-size duty gun. This is your Glock 21 and 45 ACP. So this is a large, big bore, as they call it, caliber. A lot of police departments also carry this. Anyway, John Moses Browning created the 1911. And it was for 45 ACP, and I think he designed it in the late 1800s. So this particular round's been a long time, been around a long time in this country, and not only police departments, but our troops, your fathers, grandfathers, and great-grandfathers probably carried this pistol caliber in World War I, World War II. I mean, it's been in literally every war since 1911. And we'll show some size differences with this. All right, so here we get into our Glock 19, your Glock 23, and an older model Glock 23. And we'll go through these, and then I'll sort of tell you the differences. But basically, the only difference between this line of a pistol with your 19s and 23s with a compact line, the only real difference is it holds two fewer rounds than the big brother, and I mean that's basically it. I mean, the grip's a little shorter and the barrel's a little shorter. Now, a lot of police departments also carry this as their duty gun. I do know that LAPD, they issue the Glock 19 to their police officers, and also NYPD. All right, so we've covered the compacts. Now let's go on to the subcompacts. All right, so this is a Glock 26 in 9mm. This is my everyday carry gun, and I'll get into why I love this gun, and it's my everyday carry here in just a second. So 9mm Glock 26. Now, they also make the Glock 27. We'll move the Glock 30 down, and guess what? It's the same gun. There's no difference. Exactly the same gun. You can take the barrel out of a Glock 26 and run it in a Glock 27. Can't with a conversion barrel.
Conversion barrel.
With a conversion barrel. Now, with a 357, you can. So you can interchange those different barrels. Now, I'll do a caveat onto putting a 9mm barrel into a 40. When you run a conversion barrel in it, it's just got thicker walls because the 40 caliber with the bore is just a little bit, the diameter is larger. So they got to beef up the 9mm barrel to make it fit in 40 for it to function properly. Now, then with our subcompact, then this is a 45 subcompact. Now, before you're wondering what the crap this is, I like to stipple my guns. Jeff hates it, but when I carry, I don't like this rubbing against my skin all the time. So it's not electrical tape, it's bicycle inner tube. It's actually a really good grip, but anyway, it doesn't rough up my skin. So you'll see I set up my gun similar with same particular type of night sights. But anyway, this is a big bore 45. This holds 10 rounds of ACP. Unlike this, it holds 13 rounds. So just a little bit more compact and a little bit smaller of a grip and a barrel. All right, so now what I'm going to go into is some of the interchangeability. And I'm try not to jump too far all over the place, but to give you an example with the 9mm line. So here's a Glock 17 full size, here's a Glock 19 compact size, and then here's a Glock 26 subcompact size. So I'm going to remove the magazines from this gun and then show you a little of the compatibility, the cool compatibilities of these particular guns. Now, right here I've got a Glock 19 magazine. Well, guess what? Cool thing about Glocks are they interchange. So that will fit, will wrap around, and function flawlessly. Now, I can add the full size. Now, if you guys ever watch Hickok 45 or know him, he does a pretty cool review over mag compatibilities. And he shoots a lot with this. He doesn't use it as a grip, so to say. He likes to use only these two fingers, but you can check him out. But Same thing with the 23. So they're all the same. You know, this is basically the same grip as the 23, the 40, and the 9mm. I mean, it's basically the same pistol, just your upper receiver's different, but, well, I mean, same deal. All right. And you hear that positive click. Now, for your 45, they're also interchangeable. Matter of fact, every Glock pistol caliber and the different sizes, they're all interchangeable. So you got your Glock 21 with holds 13 rounds. You can run that into your Glock 30. Okay. Hear the positive lock. It's going to work and wreck around.
That doesn't work with the 36.
That is correct. The 36 is a single stack Glock. I wish we had one. Matter of fact, I've wanted one for a long time. Just got so thin. But for me, I don't think I really need it because I like the higher round capacity. But the Glock 36 is pretty much this gun in 45 ACP, but it's thinner. Don't have the specs, but it's more likely light, about as thin as a 9mm. Now, if you can see, I don't know if you can get that, Jeff, but you can tell a pretty noticeable thickness on these two guns. Some people don't like the big frame of the 45. They think it's too thick. For me, when I carry this gun, I carry it outside the waistband, concealed, or inside. If I carry it inside, it's not too thick, honestly. I mean, if you have the right holster, and we'll cover that in just a second. Now, with the 45, we also need to discuss a couple of different frames for these two particular guns in Gen 3, all right, with the 45 line. Now, in 45, you're only going to get a Glock 30. In a double stack 45, you're only going to get a Glock 30, and you're only going to get a Glock 21. Now, some people might think, well, that grip is too fat. Well, they have a slim frame version. This Glock isn't a slim frame. This Glock is. All right, so the only difference, if you go into a gun shop, if you hit Jeff up or go to your local gun shop or wherever you buy guns, more likely you can find a slim frame 45 ACP Glock. I prefer the slim frame, although I don't mind shooting this gun at all. I mean, but just my preference, I like it because it's thinner. My fingers are wrapped around it a little bit better than the larger frame gun. All right, so let me try to get this back organized real quick. Jeff, am I missing anything right now?
I don't think so.
Now we're going to jump into the different generations. Again, we're not going to go too far in depth, but basically we're just going to let you know what the differences are. All right, so here is a Glock 23 Gen 2. Gen 1's are pretty rare. I would like to really get my hands on them. I've seen on Gunbroker and they're running for way too much money. Glocks aren't collectible guns. Just if anyone says, well, this Glock is collectible, some people try to say, well, these flat dark earth frame, or they're collectible, and to me, a Glock's never going to be collectible. They're plastic guns. They're polymer guns. They're not pretty. They're not nice to look at. The main difference is, and what I like about this gun over the Gen 3, is it doesn't have finger grooves. Now, on most of my guns, mine still have finger grooves. I hate finger grooves in the compact 19 and 23s. I hate the finger grooves. And I'll get into my modifications on this, but I won't go too far in depth. But this is a Gen 3, but it looks a little different. So if you notice the big difference between these two guns, you'll notice that this has finger humps, or finger grooves, whatever you want to call it. It's got little humps there. All right, and this gun, the one on the bottom, does not. All right, so I'll actually prefer that. Another difference is this has a rail for a light that you can mount a Streamlight on, or Surefire, or whatever you want to run. You can run that on the Gen 3 because it has that rail. Okay, it just slides on there. Unlike this, you can't. Now, they make aftermarket products. I haven't been too impressed with the aftermarket products. Okay, so basically we explained some of the subcompacts, differences between the generation. So I'm going to move on into what I would carry for me for everyday carry. I'll go into some of the holsters selection, and there's a million for these guns. And we'll discuss a few modifications that you might make on your own, or you might be able to purchase if you really feel like you need to. Maybe your little experience with Glock, and maybe you just kind of want some enhancements. But that said, though, please note that there's nothing that you're going to buy that's going to make you a better shooter, except going to the range and shooting, except for buying ammo. There is no grip force adapter, there's no sights, there's no grips, there's no stippling, there's no size of gun that's really going to make you a better shooter and help you apply the fundamentals taught by an instructor, someone that knows what they're doing, someone with experience. And a lot of times you can get great ideas from videos like YouTube, but you really can't learn until you get out there and put rounds down range, or you get some good dry fire practice. So I don't want to get too far off the Glock line, and we'll do another video talking about marksmanship and training and for the everyday guy that doesn't have a big budget. So with budget, what I would carry if I were to only have one gun, it would be the Glock 19 line. And it would be any of these models, either Glock 19 or Glock 23. I prefer the Glock 19. Jeff's actually, he's really digging the 9mm bullets. Just, I mean, we're all kind of, one way, shape, or form, experiencing the economy. And for me, it's more economical to shoot 9mm. Just the other day, I picked up 100 rounds of 9mm for $22. I'm going to spend maybe 10 bucks more on 40 caliber rounds, okay? So I'm saving money there. The 9mm round and plus P, if you get a good name brand of ammo, and there's a ton out there, but we won't get into it, has just as much capability as your 40s, your 357 SIG, and your 45. Shot placement, okay? We'll do another video on that. But go do your homework as far as bullet size. I think 9mm is perfectly fine. All right, so another reason why I choose a 19 is because between these three sizes, this fits the bill. It's right in the middle. Okay, it fits the bill for me and my concealed carry needs. If I need a full-size fighting pistol, I feel like this is a full-size fighting pistol. I believe that I could go back to Afghanistan and this be my sidearm and I'd be comfortable. Now, of course, I've got a M4, but you know, if that thing went down, I'd feel very comfortable with the Glock 19. I don't necessarily have to have the bigger one. Would I want the 26 over there in a gunfight if my primary went down and I needed this? Yeah, I wouldn't mind having it, God honest truth. This is my everyday carry though. And the reason I have this gun is because over time I was able to buy some other ones, and so I wanted something small. If I need to go bigger, or in the winter months, I could run my 19 or my 17. But if you know, some of you don't have the money to spend in guns, I mean, a lot of you got to be real budget conscious, and that's one of the reasons we want to do these videos. We want to give you the most bang for your buck, educate you on how to spend your money sort of properly. So in my opinion, this is the best all-around gun on the market you can buy, along with some Smith & Wesson M&P products. This gun, it retails, and really with all Glocks, the 40s cost a little bit more, but we'll talk 9mm, or actually the 45s cost a little bit more, but your 9mm and your 40s are about the same. A Gen 3 is going to cost you, depending on where you're at in the country, between $500 and $550. The Gen 4s are going to cost you between $550 and $600. Now, I prefer the Gen 4. Now, the reason it costs so much, you get an extra magazine, you get some back straps. So, you're definitely getting your money's worth out of the Gen 4. You're getting some extra stuff there. So, we'll talk Gen 3, though. So, $500, $550. It's going to run every time. You're not going to get a quality $300 gun. Me and Jeff talk about it all the time. You know, him being a gun dealer, they call him up. It's like, hey, I'm looking for a $300 gun. And he's like, why? They think, well, Jeff's a gun dealer. He's just trying to upsell him. And he's like, no, dude, I'm trying to educate you. In the long run, you're going to save money if you buy a Glock. Now, we already talked about Jeff being an HK guy. HKs are running $8,000, $9,000. Jeff will tell you, that's probably not, you know, just because I like it, don't mean you need one. You know, would I like you to buy it from me? Yeah, but I'm going to tell you that you're probably best off getting you a Glock, figuring out. It's going to, he would feel good about selling this to you because he knows that you can stake your life on this gun, and so do I. Now, we'll talk about accessories, and here's why I like the Glock line. I won't go too far in depth, but I'll run some stuff out there. But so we're dealing with what's the best economically priced out of accessories and guns. Well, little cheap piece of plastic made by Glock is a Glock holster. This is for a 9mm. It'll fit your Glock 17 full size, it'll fit your Glock 19 mid size, and your Glock 26. It's like a glove. In that 26, with the 26, also fits great with the 19. $20, okay? Sometimes you can get them cheaper. It just depends. I'm sure you could probably pick up a used one off eBay or wherever. They're a good little holster. Are they top quality? No, but it will serve you well. And every side Glock will fit in, okay? So that's the cool thing about Glocks is they're so mass produced that parts are cheap for them. Accessories are cheap for them, okay? Because everybody's making them. So that's another good thing. That's Jeff behind the camera with Raven One Tactical. Check him out at RavenOneTactical.com. And I'm Hank with Everyday Carry 101. Hit me up on Facebook if you got questions. Ask on YouTube, you know, whatever. I'll try to answer as quickly as possible. Jeff will try to answer you as well. Hit him up on Facebook. Just do a search for Raven One Tactical. Ask him questions all day long. I mean, the dude is literally a subject matter expert on guns. I don't really consider myself a subject matter expert. I am on a few, but definitely hit Jeff up. He knows a lot more prices, what guns are really good for, why they were made. I mean, the dude will blow your mind, okay? So hit us up. Again, thanks, and we'll see you later.